Behind me is a food bank. Now, food banks store not just food, but also other products that households need, like diapers or cleaning products. This is what typical demand for food banks looks like. And this is for the years 2004 to 2018, and this is for last year, 2019. This demand is estimated using Google searches, and it follows a similar pattern. Pretty normal demand throughout the year, but then a rise in demand around Thanksgiving and Christmas, right at the end of the year. This is what demand looks like this year in 2020. The pandemic lockdowns have had a huge increase in demand for food banks. And the question is, how do we handle this demand? Do we need to be worried about this demand going forward? Well, what I want to talk about today is how some economists designed auctions that help feed the poor through food banks. When we talk about economics and markets having the power to shape the world, usually we're talking about when a new technology or a new policy comes in and changes incentives, we see people respond. A good example of this is that a case of cell phones coming to Kerala, India, and transforming the fish market, which you can find that video up here. These kind of things are like observing natural physical phenomena, like taking a spark and fuel and then creating a flame. But we could take another tack with this, where we actually use economics to design the world around us. This is more like taking that spark and that fuel and then creating something that transforms the world. This year's Nobel Prize in Economics went to Paul Milgram and Bob Wilson for their work on auction theory. And auction theory is a great example of economists as engineers, going in and actually finding out how we can structure the incentives and the economics of the situation to make people better off. And one application of auction theory came to food banks. Food banks had this problem that they were facing, and some economists came in and said, we can use auctions to fix that problem. The food bank situation we're gonna look at is with Feeding America. Feeding America is a network of food banks across the United States, and they help get food to food banks to be distributed to the poor. Now, this is a natural place for economists to come in and help because you have these resources, this supply from Feeding America that needs to get out to demand, to all those food banks. And so there's gonna be some allocation process that needs to be determined. And the problem is, you're probably not gonna be able to use prices, at least not directly. And it turns out that the system that Feeding America was using before the economists came in had some serious problems. On the demand side, these food banks would go in their pantries and they could see they have a lot of goods, such as like some canned goods, maybe a lot of top ramen, but they are lacking peanut butter. They really need peanut butter because that's in high demand in their area. Well, Feeding America gets shipments of food that they can give out to these food banks, and they wanted to make sure that they were given to people according to their needs. Food banks would be put into a queue where their rank in that queue was determined by the needs of their food bank. Needs were determined by the people they were serving, the incomes in those areas, a couple of different things, so that the food banks with the greatest needs were getting food more often. When a shipment would come in, they would notify the queue, and the person at the front of the queue would have that opportunity to go get the food. Now, here is one of the problems. The first problem here is that this system only allowed you to contact one food bank at a time. Whoever's at the front of the queue, they get called up and they get to decide whether they're gonna take the donation or not. And they would have time, like 4 to 6 hours. Well, this can take a long time to get through that queue. You can see that, like, just giving each food bank 4 to 6 hours is gonna very quickly add up to a whole day on a time-sensitive issue. These donations need to be shipped across the country. They're coming from big stores. They're coming from big YouTubers. They are things that people need to take care of right now. Now, the decision to accept a donation is a little bit tricky because often you don't know what you're getting or what's coming in the future. And this brings us to the second problem. Sometimes you would accept a shipment that you didn't value that much. It was not full of peanut butter, it was full of top ramen, something you already have. While another food bank would have really wanted to get that top ramen. So you might be taking something that another food bank really want.
Or another way to put this is that the value that you put on this item is lower than the value another food bank would have put on it. And it would have been more efficient to give that other food bank this delivery. There's no way for us to know what the current needs are for each food bank on any given day. We can only contact one at a time, and so we can't go around and ask everybody who needs this. We have no way of figuring out the preferences of these food banks, and this is where the auction comes in. The economists come in and say, this is a clear case where we need to bring in an auction, and you think, oh, well, that's all they did is they brought in an auction. No, you have to make sure that you design this auction in a way that's going to be fair, that still accomplishes the goals that the food network has. What's a way that this auction could be unfair? Well, how are food banks going to pay for this auction? Usually you use cold hard cash, but this is where you might have some problems. Imagine you have a shipment of peanut butter up for auction and you have two food banks, one that is flush with resources and one that is not. They don't get as many cash donations from their community. That poor food bank could put all of its money towards that shipment and still lose to the rich food bank that has more money and therefore can easily spend on that shipment without worrying about the other things they need to spend money on. So how do you resolve this fairness issue? Well, the economists decided to just get rid of the cash and give them fake money. This is just shares. They call it shares, and it was a fake currency, but it was the currency that they were going to be using in these auctions, and they could decide how this currency was given to everybody. The way that they distributed it was according to need. They could give the poor food banks more shares and the richer food banks fewer shares. Now this poor food bank in this auction has more money that they can use to spend on the things that they need, and so they can outbid the rich food banks without worrying about wasting their own resources. Another feature of this auction was that food banks could put up their own food to be auctioned off. These food banks might receive donations from their local communities, but they might receive too much of something. And so instead of just holding on to that, having it take up space and not be used, they could actually put this up on the market and they could get it to another food bank in need. Now the question is, did it work? Under the queuing system, food banks had basically the same opportunity to get food, so they would just get it when it came to them, they could bring it in, and basically everybody gets about the same amount of food relative to their population that they're serving. So we should see just about everybody getting the same amount. So on a graph like this, let's just say this is the amount of food per need that you're getting, we would expect to see right here in the middle, everybody right around here. But in reality, what we see is that it becomes much more dispersed. The food banks that need more food because they don't get as many donations, they are able to acquire more food. And the ones that aren't as in need, they don't participate in the auction as much because they don't need that food. And so we actually get a fairer distribution. Now, fairer in this case is some food banks get more food than others, but that's what we want when there's inequalities before they get to those donations. Another example of how well this worked comes from those food items that the food banks themselves could put on the auction. Remember, if they had too much of something, they could put it up for auction and other food banks had the opportunity to buy it from them. Well, immediately, 12 million pounds of food went on the market from food banks putting up their surplus and other food banks receiving that. That is an amazing reallocation of resources. That's the kind of thing we want in the market. We want people to be able to say, hey, we don't need this as much, or we could get other things if we sell this and we have better opportunities to buy on the market to get what we really need. This auction brought these food banks together under a more efficient allocation of food resources. This is using economics to design a better way to feed the poor. If you're interested in some of the other cool things that auctions can do, you should go check out this video where I sold a $1 bill for a pretty big profit using auctions. And you should also check out some of these other videos where I just try to make economics fun. And I invite you to join this community of people interested in and excited about economics. We will see you next time.